Hello and welcome to Cloud Tech Talks. This is Pritesh. I'm back with another video, and today is about part 4 of must-have cloud solutions for the new normal. And we are going to talk about CASB and DLP. So let's get started. Before I get started with the video, I just wanted to make a very simple request for you to like, share and subscribe to this channel. Please share it with your family, with your friends, and please do comment if you have any suggestions or feedback for the kind of videos that I'm making, whether it's about the quality, whether it's about the content, I'd really appreciate it. Thank you. So let's look at the definition of CASB and DLP. CASB is nothing but Cloud Access Security Broker, and DLP is nothing but Data Loss Prevention Software. So no need to get into the complexity of what those terms mean specifically. I'll try to really simplify the concepts for you by running you through some of the use cases and business benefits for both CASB and DLP. For most of the time, both of these solutions are part of one single solution given coming from a security provider, right? So the leading security players in the industry, they typically have a software which can do the functioning for a data loss prevention and the CASB at the same time. And that's what we are going to run through from a use case and a business benefit perspective. So the first use case that I wanted to talk about is getting visibility for data and also making sure that the employees are abiding by the compliance policies for the organization. Now, visibility for data can mean different things for different individuals, but from a CASB and DLP perspective, it's more about can you really control and govern what kind of applications that the user is using for for his work during a given day in his routine? Is he sharing information from those applications outside the organization, which he's not supposed to do, or can IT get access and insights to all of this information from a single window pane or console, right? So that's the first use case that I wanted to talk about. The second one is about identifying the risk of cloud services being used in the organization. Now, needless to say, the advent of cloud has really brought about use of professional and personal cloud solutions for a given company and a given environment, right? But how can you make sure that you are able to identify the risks associated to specific personal cloud subscriptions or professional cloud subscriptions in use for that given organization? So classic example is when a specific function or a department, they sign up for a enterprise file sync and share service because the IT department does not have the ability to grant access to a software which can send data in gigabytes, right? So how the functional head makes a decision for himself, for his department, to be able to share information outside the organization or even within his professional group as well. So can you identify the risk associated to use such a software for your organization? That's one of the key use cases for CASB and DLP. The third and I think the most important thing that I wanted to talk about from a use case perspective is to be able to maintain an audit trail, and also in case of a compliance or a legal angle coming into picture, can you actually do a forensic investigation and discovery, right? So let's assume that an employee gets filed a suit against himself, and his information and his audit trail needs to be examined from an audit perspective from that console, right? So can IT give that single dashboard view with the right audit trail click by click for a forensic investigator to come into the organization and look at the audit trail from start to beginning, from start to finish, and can that proved to be crucial evidence in that lawsuit as well, right? So that's one of the important points that I wanted to discuss from a use case perspective. Last but not the least, to make sure that you are ensuring security, data sovereignty policies are in place and compliance standards are in place, regardless of what industry we are talking about. So these are on a high level the use cases of CASB and DLP. Let's flip the side towards the business benefits and understand what the business benefits are for CASB and DLP. The first one is to be able to protect sensitive information in the cloud and beyond. Now, obviously, most of these organizations are operating from different places around the world now, and this data is now residing in the cloud for most of these people. So you want to make sure that once you have given access, you want to protect that information, even if it means it is in the cloud, so that additional layer of security even in the cloud. So most CASB and DLP players, they have now an end-to-end integration with the cloud sub service providers like Microsoft or Google, etc., to provide that additional layer of security that is needed for sensitive information, right? So you could be dealing with GDPR policies or any specific privacy policy norms that apply to that country or continent. So that's why this protective of sensitive information is of utmost importance. The second business benefit that I wanted to talk about is to be able to encrypt and decrypt sensitive information for the company, right? So encryption is applicable for banking organizations or healthcare organizations or any kind of industries which are dealing with very sensitive information which is confidential either to that company or to that specific country or from a data governance standpoint as well. So how can you ensure encryption and decryption and tokenized sensitive information for access only to the right people in that given organization? Third, how do you make sure that you are 100% compliant and you are able to comply not only with the rules and regulations of that given company, but also with the rules and regulations of that given country or continent, right? So 100% compliance from start to finish. And last but not the least, from a business benefit perspective, is you have to be able to make sure that you gain essential intelligence and be threat aware all the time, right? So many times the best policy to secure yourself against a given hack or a given threat is to make sure that you have intelligence beforehand, get access to sensitive information or rather suspicious behavior from different sets of users and communities of that given organization, so that you never really lead to a point where an attack is actually implemented or a user is put to risk in any way, shape and form. So on a high level, this is what I wanted to discuss from a use case and benefit perspective for CASB and DLP. I hope the information was useful. If you like the video, please hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, do share it with your friends and family. Until next time, this is Pritesh signing off from Cloud Tech Talks. Thank you.